It's golf's big kahuna, the 100th PGA Championship at Belle Reve in St. Louis.
It's getting to be that time of year. There are going to be people out there who go under and don't come back up. We're going to take you along for search and rescue training like you've never seen. It was all for Special Olympics, and thankfully, Lisa Hart from Fox 2 News in the Morning was there to help me over the edge. Watch.
Andy, how are you?
Not good.
He's a total wreck.
As I was shaking, Lisa was almost strutting with confidence, though she had a misstep at first. She caught up to me. A new book just out from Benji Molina, Yadier's brother. Or is Yadier your brother?
He's
your brother. It's called Molina, the story of a father who raised an unlikely baseball dynasty. Welcome to Fox 2 News in the Morning.
Thank you for having me.
And this is a great book.
And you knew this was going to be a great opening day by the way it got started. Hall of Famer Lou Brock throwing out the ceremonial first pitch.
That'll do it from Ballpark Village. Banging the victory drums. Mandy Shirley.
It's a party. Andy's playing the drum.
It's time to get on your feet for your St. Louis Rams.
And then running back number 30, Todd Gurley.
Shocking attacks in Paris this evening. Our MC is Andy
Bank. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise now for a moment of silence. We pause to mourn those victims from today's attacks in Paris. We ask that you join us in remembering these individuals and their loved ones. Thank you.
And that moment, beautifully observed.
I think Will Smith nailed it in a lot of ways.
I agree.
But my personal feeling about Omalu and having spent some time with him is that he's much more flamboyant.
Like Will Smith said in the movie Concussion, God did not intend for us to play football.
A star-spangled honor for a Special Olympics athlete.
Joseph Niemeyer Jr. sang the national anthem before the St. Louis Blues game last night. Fox 2's Andy Banker is here now with the story all new at 6, and it is a good one.
He's the big man on campus at Rockwood Summit High School, let me tell you. And really, it was that way before the game. You could tell from his cheering section, family, classmates, coaches, and he blew them all away.
A shot, he scores!
The Blues won, but the highlight of the night came before the puck ever dropped.
Joe!
Rockwood Summit senior Joseph Niemeyer Jr. sang the national anthem alongside fan favorite Charles Glenn.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light?
How loud was that for those cheers?
Pretty loud, but when I hit the high notes, I never heard them once.
He's an inspiring young man of many hats, student, baseball, and football team manager. He even helps out in the school office, making the occasional delivery to teachers before the end of the school day.
Okay, thank you. Let's go.
God bless America.
Of more than 650 contestants who submitted videos to the Blues and the St. Louis Symphony in the search for an anthem singer, Joe was one of 34 called to audition at Powell Hall. Charles Glenn was one of the judges.
Right then, before he ever left the stage, Charles got up and gave him a hug and said, hey, I want you to sing with me.
Come here, give me some love, baby.
But my favorite part was singing with Charles Glenn. It was fun, me and him hit the high notes, and it was just fun.
In the home of the brave.
Him standing there with his tux and his scarf just like Mr. Glenn, you know, it was very emotional for me. It was just magical.
That was his mom you heard there. She says if you think he can sing, you should see him dance. Joe also has represented St. Louis in the Special Olympics in tennis, guys.
Wow.
Really. Oh, my gosh.
I know.
And Charles Glenn, I mean, just gave that that young man such a great opportunity.
He saw him at Powell and said, you're singing.
Give me some love, he says. Oh, I love it. All right, Andy, thank you so much.
Hey, good morning, Charlie. You know, we still do not have the official sheet on who's in and who's out for today's game, but the word in the dome this morning is that Wes Welker will certainly be in, especially on third downs. Oh, hear me anyway. Andy Banker with Fox in St. Louis.
Again, you have a TV voice, Andy.
Yeah. Thank you. This is piggybacking on David's question.
Time now for the national anthem, and let's join the public address announcer, Andy Banker.
Ladies and gentlemen, to honor America, please stand and remove your hats as classically trained American violinist Bobby Yang plays our national anthem. Wow, beautiful.
We concur. Coverage of tonight's national anthem has been presented.
Ballpark Village below the big screen outside is so empty right now that Steve Melton, who's here with a bunch of his buddies for his bachelor party, have started a wiffle ball game, and he's going to put one in there for me. Let's go, Steve. This is the best way to keep warm tonight. But you got to hit something. After 6 weeks, the Rams are 3-3 after essentially running the Houston Texans off of their own home field. This game reminded you a lot of last week's game in Houston, but in reverse. Good morning and welcome to another edition of Cardinals Confidential, your all-access pass to the St. Louis Cardinals.
Good to see you, Wayno. Thanks for coming in.
Yeah, I'm fired up to be here.
All right, how's that sound? Hammonds Field in Springfield, Mo Rich, is absolutely crazy tonight. The lines to get in reminded you of Busch Stadium. So does this. Look out there at the mound. See the man? Chris Carpenter, typical crowd here, about 4,600. We're going to have 10,000 or more here now. This place is absolutely packed. I talked to a couple from St. Louis. They heard Carp was going to be here. They were at the Lake of the Ozarks, so they drove over here. They got a blanket somewhere out here in the outfield, and they're sitting in it. They got general admission tickets. First pitch, strike one. Welcome back, Chris Carpenter. What a blast. You think they're excited about seeing this in Springfield? They are in St. Louis, too. Strike two. Let's watch his first batter, see if we get a K here, Rich.
That's I'm with,
okay
you.
With you. You cool with that?
You bet. You keep
all
going.
Right. Make.
You've got the play-by-play, Andy Banker.
I don't know who's Hammonds batting, field. Though, for the Arkansas Travelers.
It doesn't
got
really
him. He got him. Welcome back, Carp. Three pitches. Three strikes. Sit down, minor. Son.
Big night and all new at 6 o'clock tonight. A look at the Guns N' Hoses event like you've never seen before.
Yeah, we go in depth with a police officer who's putting his face on the line for the cause. Fox 2's Andy Banker is here now with the story only on Fox. Andy.
It could come away with some stitches. We hope not. We wanted to know what drives these people to do this, right? We got 32 men and women going to be getting into the ring tomorrow night, facing a crowd of close to 20,000 and someone who's going to be hitting them very hard. Well, this is why.
Do you have your backpack?
When you're a five-year-old like Lily Sturr, there's no thought of daddy maybe going to work one day and never coming back, not being there anymore to hold your hand on the way to school.
See, they made it just on time, Lily.
But though she may not think of those things, her daddy has to.
Oh, you know, working every day, you know, not making home to your family, and that crosses my mind.
So for the past few months, Eric Sturr, St. Louis County police officer, has been turning himself into Eric Sturr, heavyweight boxer, adding to his already loaded work schedule.
Just see what you're made of, you know.
Just the workload itself was a lot. And now he wanted to add on going to the gym regularly and training too. And I'm like, are we ever going to see you?
Sturr patrols Jennings, responding to everything from burglaries to shootings. And when he's not working here, he works part-time security at a library in North County. The things he sees on the job and on the news are a big part of why he's fighting.
Just driving, you have to look around. Look at the cars next to you, look at the car in front of you, look at the people walking next to you. You always have to be on alert. You never know. You have to be ready. You can't play any call cheap.
He was only an acquaintance of slain St. Louis County Police Officer Blake Snyder. They once both worked in Afton on different shifts, but at similar places in their lives when Snyder was killed in the line of duty.
You know, I was at his funeral, and it's just heartbreaking.
It's really fun to see them get in the ring, get there, and
fight it out.
Snyder's widow, Elizabeth, is one of Guns N' Roses' biggest promoters. She and her son are direct beneficiaries. The police versus firefighters boxing match has raised a record $653,000 last year for the Backstoppers, the charity that covers expenses like mortgages, college tuition, and counseling for the families of the fallen. It is a life rope. She wants people like Sturr to know the payoff for putting their family time and their faces on the line.
Aww. I break a nose, you know. I know, they put up a lot, you know, for this fight. It's getting better in the way that I'm not crying every other second, if that makes sense. And I'm learning to pick up the pieces of my life and start to move forward with things.
Sturr also has Lily's little sister, Charlotte, counting on him. Taking a punch seems like the least he can do. His wife supports him, though she won't watch the fight.
No, I'm pretty not face. Worried about his pretty face. He's a tough guy. He can hang with the best, so he'll be fine.
I'm not rich. I can't, like, contribute tons of money, but I have a body, and I have no problem getting punched in the face. So I'll go out there and do my part. It's not for me, just like, you know, thank my family's taken care of. It's for anyone, you know, it's for Elizabeth. It's for, you know, anyone that loses their husband, their wife, anyone in the line of duty, their son, anything.
Can't let my friends down. I'm ready.
Time!
He has the first match of the night tomorrow, and then he has to work the next day, Thanksgiving. And guys, we talk about his putting his face on the line.
Yeah.
That's true. But organizers say safety is a top priority. They never let this get out of hand. They've got 6 ringside doctors, ambulances waiting just in case, but no one has ever been seriously hurt in a Guns N' Roses bout.
But they box like you want to see. Like, they really box. There's not all this dancing. They go at it.
And they train for it for weeks and weeks leading up to it.
He took some shots.
Yeah,
training,
right.
Didn't he?
I love his wife. I'm not worried about his pretty face.
See his opponent tomorrow night. She ought to be worried.
Yeah, yeah. All right, Andy.